In the year 2026 AD, the earth-wrenched tectonic disturbance occurred around the world, splitting the earth into four terrestrial masses. Domination, war, disaster, and famine broke out in the forest, and mankind fell into disarray. In the center of the world, a single tower rose steeply into the sky. It was a great structure looking down on the earth from the heavens above. People believed that it held the key to the future. It became known as the Tower of Ours, a place in which one could come close to God.
Everybody, this is Afro X, and here I am giving you gameplay as much as I can of this new free-to-play game that is on the PlayStation Store right now, which is called Let It Die. Hope you enjoy.
Looks like things are about to get busy around here.
Guess I get to pick my character. There's a female and those are male. So I will pick a male one.
This is your first time riding line 15, huh? I know, it's not a very well-known line, I admit. Anyway, this is the last stop. Oh yeah, here, take this. It's called an underwater Rolodex. And it's super important.
Did he say underworld or underwater? Because I don't really want to be underwater.
I forgot to mention, my name is Uncle Death. I have a feeling we're gonna get along just fine.
Well, he seems fun. Alright guys, I've played a little bit of this, and I'm actually starting the game over just for this gameplay, but I also saw a gameplay of it on YouTube. So this part right here is just a little loading screen. Fire riding up the escalator. Ooh, sorry for yawning. Early morning. But it's done quickly. Ikigara. Ikigara. Japanese pronunciation. But whatever.
Hey, senpai, it's me. This device here, as all the cool kids call it, is a smartphone. I'll be keeping in touch.
Thanks, Uncle Death. Thank you for playing Let It Die on the Death Drive 128. Please read Barb's Bible thoroughly to aid you in your brutality. You can view it at any time in the Underworld Rolodex. You can open the Underworld Rolodex from the Options menu. Now, if you guys also have this game, I'd really encourage you to play through it with me. Because it's really fun and it'd be nice to actually guide some people. Many pieces of equipment are featured in the game. Let's take a look at a few basic rules. Equipment includes weapons which may be equipped on the right, left, or both hands, and three types of armor: head, upper body, and lower body. Every piece of equipment has durability, which increases each time it is used. When the durability reaches zero, the equipment will break, so be careful. There are single-handed weapons, which you can equip in each hand, and double-handed weapons, which you can only equip one of. It is your choice which weapon you become proficient with. You can store and carry the various items you find in the tower in your death bag. Both left and right arm have three weapon slots. Use the directional buttons to quickly switch between weapons equipped in these slots.
Yeah, you should be able to jump and shimmy up there somehow.
The game doesn't tell you, but on a PS4 controller, you jump by pressing square. Well, you might have already realized that by now. Rage moves. In this game, you can unleash rage moves, techniques which are stronger than regular attacks. If you use these effectively, you will have an advantage in battle. Each time you deal damage to an enemy, your rage will build. This will increase in level until it reaches the maximum. When the rage gauge is full, hold triangle as you attack to unleash a powerful rage move with your equipped weapon. The number of gauges used up by the rage move depends on the weapon you are holding.
Shut up!
healing mushrooms. You'll encounter various types of mushroom in this game. They have many uses, but here we'll explain their role as food items. When you draw close to a mushroom, you can consume it quickly by selecting the eat icon, which will be displayed. When you put mushrooms in your death bag, they will be displayed in the flick box at the top right of the screen. Click on the mushroom you want to eat with the touchpad, and eat it by clicking the right side of the touchpad button. Not all mushrooms are beneficial to the player. Some mushrooms contain poison that can result in death, so be careful.
Eat mushrooms! That's a given. Feeling pretty pumped now, huh? Good thing it wasn't poisonous.
Gear elements. There are six types of equipment: slashing, blunt, piercing, fire, lightning, and poison. You can hold up to two types of weapon at the same time. It's important to pay attention to the type of armor your enemy is wearing and manage your weapons accordingly. Armor has a defense value that varies with the type. It's important to pay attention to the enemy's weapon and switch accordingly. Now we're gonna collect these mushrooms, and you'll see why in a minute. That girl knows why.
Wanna give me some of those mushrooms?
Well, did the wrong thing with them. Throwing mushrooms. You will encounter both mushrooms and beasts in this game. Let's look at how to throw mushrooms. Choose a mushroom you wish to throw by flicking the touchpad to select one, and click the left side of the touchpad button to switch to throw mode. In this mode, you can throw mushrooms by pressing X. And I did it again.
Thank you.
Yeah, you'd think running this way she would have grabbed this balloon. Gortastic attack. When you make an enemy groggy, that's when you can release a gortastic coup de grace. These moves are so awesomely brutal that you might even want to cover your eyes. Making an enemy groggy. By unleashing a continuous barrage of attacks on the enemy, you can make them groggy. Of course, this can happen to your character as well, so take care. Using Gortastic. By approaching an enemy in a groggy state, hold triangle and press an attack button. A Gortastic attack will activate depending on the weapon used. Gortastic experience. If you defeat an enemy using a Gortastic attack, you will receive more rewards than usual. Don't hold back now.
Senpai! Can't wait to see you in your next battle!
What the hell? No. Okay. Oh, it's you.
Wanna try again? Oh, wait. Let me put the title logo up real quick. You know how these things go.
Woohoo!
Let it die.
I'm going to leave this playthrough there for a little bit, and, well, wait, actually, there's one more scene after this. But yeah, after this next scene, I'm gonna leave this playthrough, and then we can continue, probably in a couple of weeks.
Thank you for listening to this voice guidance system. Let us embark on a journey of discovery about the many wonders of the Tower of Barbs. The Tower of Barb is located on the tiny 3.7 square mile island of South Tokyo. Legend has it that this island was formed during the Earth Rage tectonic disturbance of 2026. The tower stands at 1,686 feet, the equivalent of a 30-story building with super high ceilings. Many say that the tower is actually growing with each passing year. Legend has it that a great treasure lies at the top of the tower. As such, many brave people often attempt to climb the tower to obtain those riches. However, none have managed to survive the tower's horrific trials, and thus, the tower stands as a grim reminder of the many lives lost in search of this mythical treasure. I hope that you too will enjoy your climb of the tower and experience the many wonders that it has to offer.
Finally waking up. You seem sleepy, so I turned it off. Huh? I'm talking about the Death Drive 128, of course, man. You were just playing it, remember? Hey, pretty cool, huh? Pretty badass? It's the best game console ever, and this game, Let It Die. It's probably the greatest game ever made. The goal of the game is pretty simple. Just make it to the top of the Tower of Barbs. It's like a hack and slash, roguelike kind of a thing. What the?
Hey, dude, you're a gamer, aren't you?
Then you'll totally be fine. Just try it out.
I'll set it up for you. Okay, all ready to go? Let's get started!
I'll start the game.
Uncle Death here again. You know, you should subscribe. It's the only way to see more clips of Let It Die. Anyways, keep YouTubing, YouTubers. Don't fight the pro, and always remember to stay legendary. See you later.